由美国总统盾牌华人主席 Mina Holmes 及神奇传播周一方博士共同举办的加州州长候选人坚尼瑞媒体见面会于上周六举办，希望借由此参会让加州华人选民更多地认识参选人坚尼瑞。
I'll share with you a few things that I've heard from the Chinese community so far. The first one is education. Critical race theory should not be taught in our schools. Affirmative action has no place in our schools in California. We need an overhaul of the schools, not just to push back on the things that are wrong, but to reinvent the future of the way we think about our schooling in California. And we need education reform to focus on environmental and engineering. The second thing that's important that I've heard from our Chinese and our Asian communities is safety. We need our cities to be safe again. And right now, there is a movement to defund the police. I am against defunding the police. So we need to support the police, invest in the police, and create good laws. There's also a movement to close our prisons. Two prisons will close this year if Gavin Newsom stays in office. The prisons that we have and our prisoners to have work programs so that they can work on our forest fires, so that they can work on our streets to keep them clean.
坚尼瑞是一位杰出商业与科技的企业主，常春藤 MBA， 经营美国顶尖企业顾问公司，和先生居住于北加州，是三位男孩的母亲。眼看走向败坏的加州，身为成功企业管理的他决心出马竞选。他有着与一般政客不一样的思维，针对加州面临游民问题、犯罪问题、高税收、企业外移等问题提出实际解决方案。靠着他在经营企业得到的经验以及他的信仰，他将要带领加州走出目前在企业出走、治安恶化、教育败坏、山火蔓延、非法移民等诸多方面的严峻困境。他将以明确数据指出加州面临的严峻问题，并提出相应的解决方案。他也特别重视亚裔和少数族群，因此录制了一系列的影片来讨论亚裔最关注的问题。
Since Gavin Newsom took office, we've had a rise in homelessness. His first year, he spent $1 billion on homelessness. His second year, he spent $4 billion on homelessness. This year, he's spending $12 billion on homelessness. So the money he's spending is encouraging the homeless to move to California, not fixing the homeless problem. I have a plan, it's on my website, it's called Spend Smarter for Homelessness. And the focus is on using the money for the things that help our homeless get off the street. Mental health support, substance abuse support, and required housing.
在加州州长纽森的治理下，加州已有超过500,000人出走。纽森已让许多加州居民极为失望，在9月14日的罢免投票时，呼吁加州居民踊跃参与罢免，同时选出新任州长。